Welcome to our November house party. In case you don't know me, my name is Sol and I'm so happy to see you. Since Thanksgiving is right around the corner, we're going to party and learn some more about gratitude. To get started, we're going to play a game. Let's go.
Thank you.
to move into a time of worship. I want you to stand up and get ready to give God praise and show gratitude for all He does for you every day.
Hey there, Destiny Church. I hope that you're ready to praise the Lord today wherever you are. Let's stand up if you can. We're gonna start off with an upbeat song. So let's raise our voice, let's clap our hands to the King. Come on.
When night has fallen and fear is calm, still you're calling me. When faith is lost, my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on, it won't let go.
I'm so thankful. I think I'm more thankful than most people. Yep. Thankful for my car. I love my car. Yep. I'm thankful that they brought back Twinkies. Yep. Thankful that my phone reminds me of my kids' birthdays. Hashtag close call. Yep. You ever wonder what the Puritans did before they invented Kindles? Nope. Probably play with dirt. Thankful I'm not a Puritan. Yep. Thankful for my gym membership. I mean, look at me. Yep. What are you thankful for? I'm thankful. thankful for a God who loves me unconditionally.
Yeah.
I mean, even when I make a mess of things, he still loves me.
Yep.
No, seriously, I don't think about that enough. I'm really, really thankful for that.
I was gonna say all that stuff. I just didn't know we were talking about spiritual things.
Yep.
You make me want to be a better man.
Yep.
Hey guys, in case you don't know me, I'm Riley, and welcome to our November house party. I'm really glad to see you, and I hope that you've been having a fun time so far. So, today we're going to be talking Thanksgiving and how to have an attitude of gratitude. I know, it sounds cheesy. Stay with me. Living a thankful life is so much easier than living an ungrateful one. God does so much for us. He wakes us up, provides, and even died on the cross for our sins. Colossians 2, 6, and 7 tells us something about this too. It says, "So then, just as you received Christ as Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness." This verse is telling us how we should live. It says that we should live our lives in him, rooted and built up to him, strengthened in faith, and overflowing with thankfulness. Isn't that a cool thing to think of? Overflowing with thankfulness. Being so full of thankfulness that you just can't keep it into yourself and it just bubbles out of you. I would say that most of the time you're overflowing with something, even if you don't realize it, and even if it's not on purpose. Sometimes during the school year, we're overflowing with stress about homework, assignments, projects, studying. It's all we can think about, and we can't help but to overflow with it. Sometimes you're overflowing with happiness. You've just had a really great day hanging out with your friends, or you guys have plans for tomorrow, and you're just having so much fun that you're bubbling and overflowing with all of this happiness, and it just kind of goes out. Whatever you're feeling the most or thinking about the most, that's what you're going to be overflowing with. So, how do you overflow with thankfulness? Well, you first have to try. You have to make a decision to start being thankful more than you are now. Make an effort to be thankful on purpose. Don't just wait for something to come along that makes you feel thankful, but instead, actively look at all the things in your life that you're thankful for. Another way to overflow with thankfulness is to be thankful for the big things and for the little things. Don't just be thankful for the big things that happen, like getting an A in your toughest class, or getting exactly what it is that you wanted for your birthday. Be thankful for the small things too, like when your mom makes you breakfast, or when God helps you to do well on an assignment. Another thing that is sure to make you overflow with thankfulness is to make being thankful a part of your prayer life. Sure, most of us would say that we're very thankful to God and all he's done for us. We would probably all say that we're extremely thankful for the things that God has blessed us with. But when you pray, is it usually to say thank you, or is it to ask for something? We're told in Ephesians 5:20, "Always give thanks to God the Father for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." This verse says that we should always be giving thanks to God for everything. It's easy to read a verse like that and kind of skip over its actual meaning. Because seriously, give thanks for everything? Is that even possible? Here's some things. First of all, you woke up today. That's something to be thankful for all on its own. You woke up, you're breathing, and you're physically able to get out of bed. Don't you think that God deserves some thankfulness for that? Also, the sun was rising when you got up. A beautiful sunrise brought the good news that, surprise, you're not going to freeze to death today. Then you got to go to a bathroom with a working shower, toilet, and sink. You got to brush your teeth with running water without being afraid about whether or not that water is going to give you any sort of diseases. Most of the world can't say the same, so that's something worth being thankful for. And let's not forget that when you woke up into a promise of eternal life, not death. You woke up forgiven because Jesus has died for your sins. All these things have you being thankful in your day, and your day hasn't even really started yet. But did you thank God for all these things this morning? Probably not. We become so used to them that we start to take them for granted, and we forget to be thankful for them. Now, I want you to watch a video on doing an inventory of what you can thank God for.
Have you ever stopped to take an inventory of your blessings? You know, the things you should be thankful for?
Oh yeah, like Eskimo pies. I'm so thankful for them. I mean, they're ice cream and cookie put together. Thank you, Eskimo Pie people.
That's not what I'm really getting at.
Oh, you mean serious stuff. Yeah. Like zippers. I mean, where would we be without them? They let us in and out of our clothes. Up and down. Thank you.
What I want the people to do out there is just to kind of take a pause in their busy schedules and add up all the blessings no matter what circumstance they're going through.
Oh, circumstances.
Yeah.
Yeah, like the other day, my zipper was stuck. I couldn't get out. I was freaking out, right? You know? And then I thought, what if I was a spaceman? What do spacemen do when their zipper gets stuck? And then I was thankful I wasn't a spaceman.
The lights are flashing, the gate is down, but the train ain't coming, huh?
Yes! No, I don't know. I didn't have trains when I was a kid. I was more of a monkey bar guy. And I love monkey bars. I'm thankful for them. Thank you, monkey bar people!
Maybe it's been a while since you looked at your spouse, your kids, your coworkers, your family, your loved ones, and really acknowledged the joy that they bring to your life.
And I'm thankful. Thankful for teddy bears. And I'm thankful for my bald friend who really cares. And I'm thankful for the sun and the stars, the moon and the sky. And sometimes I'm so thankful that God made a guy like I. 'Cause I'm a Jim, you know.
That's it. That's it. I think you're getting the hang of this. That's good.
What do you mean?
The song you did. That was great.
Oh, I was just goofing.
Huh?
Yeah, yeah. What I'm really thankful for? Mount Rushmore.
Hey, George.
Abe.
Teddy, how'd you get up there?
Take the inventory, and I think you will realize how much God has given you, and that'll make you so thankful.
You're right. I am a blessed man. I have so many golden nuggets. I am blessed.
There you go. There you go.
I'm going to go right now.
He's going to go take the inventory.
What? No. Chicken nuggets. I love chicken nuggets. I'm thankful for them. Thank you, chicken nugget people.
I'm out of here.
If you want to overflow with thankfulness, start telling God thank you every single time that you encounter something that He's blessed you with. You won't stop saying thank you all day. 1 Chronicles 16:34 says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever." When things get tough in our lives, it can become a little bit hard to be thankful. We tend to focus on the bad stuff instead of the good stuff. And sometimes things are just going to be hard. Things in life are going to get pretty bad every now and then, but that doesn't mean that the thankfulness should ever stop. Even if you're going through a hard time where it's hard to think of things to be thankful for, you have this. The Lord is good, and His love for you endures forever. No matter what else goes wrong in your day or week or month, the Lord is good. No matter how many times you mess up, make mistakes, and fail, His love for you endures forever. And that's worth thanking Him for. Well, guys, that's all I have for you today. If you have any questions or any concerns, you can email youth@discoverdestiny.org or text 817-587-4408. Thanks for joining me. Goodbye.
Thank you so much for joining us for our November house party. I hope you had fun, and text the link to your friends if you think they'd like it too. Finally, just like last time, we want you to post a picture of yourself on Instagram or in the GroupMe and put house party and at Destiny Church FW in the caption to enter into another raffle. Anyway, see you next time.